So hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Am I visible, audible to you people? Someone in the chat box, please give confirmation. Just give me a few seconds. I can see whether I'm visible and audible to you clearly or not. So I will start it. Okay, so very good morning to all of you. I welcome you all for this session. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev, educator on an academy. So I have launched a very exciting series for you people, especially for MBBS students, that is Oncology by Dr. Priyanka. In this series, I am going to cover all tumors of the body from head to toe, one by one, system wise. So on these YouTube free sessions, I will take few tumors, and rest of the tumors I will take it on an academy platform under free special classes. So let me move ahead. So today's system is male genital system. In male genital system, I will cover tumor of three organs. First, I will cover testicular tumors, tumors of the testes. Then I will cover prostate tumors, and then I will cover penile tumors, penis tumors. So all these three tumors done today only, and all these sessions are on YouTube only. So this is the first session, and we are starting with testicular tumor. So before starting male genital system, let me tell you why I am taking few classes on YouTube and few on an academy platform. What is the difference between both the classes are free. YouTube classes are also free, as we know, and special classes under an academy are also free. The special classes under an academy are also free. But if you are attending my class under a special class, then it will be, of course, an interactive class. You can interact with me via various ways. You can interact with me via chat. You can interact with me via raise a hand feature is there. And polls are there. The most important polls are there under special classes. Under polls, I will launch MCQ from the past 5 year papers from NEET, PG, INICT and FMG. And if you have to choose correct answer, one of the correct answer from that MCQ within 15 seconds. And you can see your real time assessment. So how many students are ahead of you? How many students are behind you? What is your actual real time rank? So that will be given there. So it is very important feature, and you will always get notifications 10 minutes before the class. So you will never miss a class there. You will get PDF of the notes there, and you can attend your classes anytime, anywhere. So these are the features of special classes. So for attending special classes, what you have to do? Just go on the Play Store. From the Play Store, just download, just install the app. Which app? Install Unacademy Learners app. After installing Unacademy Learners app, go to NEET PG category. Go to NEET PG category or NEET PG in the goals. There you will get two types of classes: free classes and paid classes. And paid classes, the free classes are known as special live classes. So you can attend all my free and other educators also free classes there, and you will really enjoy it. These are live interactive classes, and you can see the recordings also later on. So please install the app and see these classes. Many important topics for NEET, PG, INICT, FMG are covered there, and that is absolutely free of cost. We also have paid classes, that is known as Plus. So we have various subscriptions for that. Various subscriptions, these are the subscriptions written in front of you. We have two type of paid classes. Number one, Plus, and number two is Iconic. In Plus, you will get, these are the prices of the subscription. Various subscriptions you can see: 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, and under Iconic you can see 12 months, 18 months. These are the subscriptions. So highest subscription is of 4 years. That is the most affordable plan. So under Iconic subscription, along with an Academy live lectures, you will also get prep ladder recorded lectures. So Iconic includes both the Plus along with prep ladder. So these are the advantages of Plus subscription. You can see, you can access your live as well as recorded lectures. You are learning from India's topmost educators. You will compete in live tests and quizzes. And we have a very advanced question bank containing 25,000 latest clinical image based question. So you can practice from it, and you will get printed notes soon. With 12 months and above subscription, students will get printed notes also. So under Iconic subscription, as I have told you, along with an Academy live and recorded lectures, you will also get prep ladder recorded lectures. So better to go with Iconic. These are the four batches which we have started yesterday or a day before yesterday, from 11th of August. So if you are an FMG student targeting FMG for December FMG or ahead of it, so please join this batch. if you are targeting next 2022, 2023, whatever next you are targeting, if you are second drop, pre-final, first drop student, please join this batch for getting maximum advantage. And if you are a NEET PG aspirant, you are targeting NEET PG, two batches are for you, NEET PG test and analysis and NEET PG ultra fast track revision for high yielding points. So these are the batches you can see there. Now, I recommend in NEET PG only 1 month or less than 1 month, I must say, remaining. Many students ask me, ma'am, what to study in the last month, last few days, what to study, what to revise, what not to revise. We have 19 subjects. So here we are to help you. There is a NEET PG 1 month package. So for very few days, this offer is valid. If you take this package in the last few days, in last month of the NEET PG, we will help you in revising entire syllabus. Entire syllabus, 19 subjects will be revised with ultra high yield revision batch. Emergency room MCQs will also, we will give you for practice. We will also give all theory as well as MCQ for COVID. You can give multiple grand test series and we will help you in solving last 3 year papers of NEET PG. So these are the advantages, and cost of this batch is only 4500 rupees. Only 4500 rupees, 4500. So I advise all the NEET PG aspirants who are going to give NEET PG next month to join this batch. And we also have, as I have told you, latest MCQ bank with us containing 25,000 high yield MCQs. This is a syllabus for grand test series, as I have told you. Now, a scholarship test is going to happen tomorrow. So I advise all the students to participate in this scholarship test. In this scholarship test, it is happening on 14th of August at 8 p.m. That is tomorrow. All NEET PG aspirants should give this test. The test is for 1 hour and it is numerical based. It is numerical based test. You will get 50 numericals, and those who will be the topper, he will get 100% scholarship for plus subscription. And from rank 2 to rank 20, they will get heavy discounts on the scholarship. Heavy discounts there. And we also have two another offers. One offer is, if you are taking 12 month subscription on plus, you will get 2 month extra. So instead of 12 months, you will get for 14 months. And we also have 4 year subscription plans. That is the most affordable, cost effective plans for plus also, for iconic also. For plus, it is only 60,000. For iconic, it is only 75,000. And you can book your month. You can convert it into monthly installments also. Just a second. Yeah, you can convert it into monthly installments. We also have a feature, ask a doubt on the app. So whatever doubt you are having in any of the 19 subjects, just take the snapshot of that doubt and post under specific subject. So whatever doubt you are having, just post under that specific subject. Our educators from the team will respond you quickly about your doubt. So don't hesitate to ask your doubt to us. Please, whatever smallest doubt you are having, please ask it. Clarify your doubts. And these are the prizes of the subscription, as I have told you. And for all these, above all these prizes, if you want discount over these prizes, so use code SACHDEV10. My code is SACHDEV10. So see the spelling. It is SACHDEV. SACHDEV10 is the code. If you apply this code just before payment, you will get 10% discount on plus as well as iconic. So let me start. Let me start with today's topic. I'm starting with oncology. Today's topic is male genital system. So I will cover all tumors from male genital system. So let me start with tumors from male genital system. In male genital system, as I have told you, I will cover three organs. So these are the three organs: penis, testes and prostate. I'm going to cover. First, I will start with testes. Then I will move to the prostate. And in the end, I will move to the penis. So let me start with testes, testicular tumors. So before starting the tumors from the testes, I would like to give a 2 minute, just a brief review about the normal structure, anatomy and histology of the testes. So you will have a better understanding about the tumors. So normal structure of the testes, testes along with epididymis. Just a second. Okay. Just a second. Okay. So testes along with epididymis, it is present in a sac known as scrotal sac, which lies outside the body. So it is present in males. In males, there is a scrotal sac. You can see here in the scrotal sac, this testes along with epididymis is present. So why it is present in another sac? It is not present in the cavity. It is not present in the pelvic cavity, abdominal cavity. It is present separately in a sac known as scrotal sac, because in testes, sperm formation takes place. We all know sperm formation requires temperature 2 degrees lesser than the core body temperature. What is the core body temperature? Human body. So at normal human body temperature, sperm formation cannot take place, for sperm formation temperature required is 2 degrees lower than the core body temperature. That's why testes are placed outside the body, not in the cavity, within the cavity, outside the cavity, outside the pelvic cavity, outside the abdominal cavity, in a separate sac. The sac is known as scrotal sac. So that is the first thing you should understand. And testes is attached with epididymis. So both are considered as a single organ, testes along with epididymis. There are two coverings over the testes. The first covering is tunica albuginea, and second covering is tunica vaginalis. Tunica albuginea is inseparable. We cannot separate it from the testes. And from the lateral and front side, there is tunica vaginalis. So I will show you. So here you can see in the diagram. Just give me 1 minute. Okay. So here in the diagram, you can see this is the testes and this is the tunica vaginalis. You can see here also, you can see tunica vaginalis on the lateral and anterior front surface. So this is tunica vaginalis. So yeah, coming on the histology, if I cut normal testes and see, make a side of it, what I will see, what is the normal histology? If you understand normal histology, no, then understanding tumors, histology, histopathology is fun for you. So normal histology, how does testes look like? So if I cut testes and see, this is the diagram of testes. So what is the diagram here showing? So testes is showing multiple luminated organs. These are known as tubules. This is a tubule. This is a tubule, you can see. This is a tubule. So these are tubules. These are known as seminiferous tubules. These are seminiferous tubules having lumen inside it. So multiple seminiferous tubules are present. Number one, seminiferous tubules are lined by two types of cells. You can see, let me mark the two type of cells. So seminiferous tubules are lined by two types of cells. The innermost lining is known as germ cells. This is from the germ cells. You can see these sperms are formed. Can you see these sperms? Spermatids or sperms are formed. So these are known as spermatogenic cells or germ cells. So spermatogenic cells or germ cells forms the inner lining. That is the inner lining of the testes coming on the outer lining. So can you see the outer lining? This one, the outermost cell, I'm marking with green. This one, the outer lining, multilayered lining. These are known as Sertoli cells. So Sertoli cells are supportive cells. These are supportive cells. They provide nourishment to these germ cells. And they also produce hormones, especially testosterone, but a small amount of estrogen also. So testosterone and estrogen. So what are the two types of cells? Who will tell me? So there are multiple tubules known as seminiferous tubules. Number one, seminiferous tubules. And the background is known as stroma. Let me mark stroma also with a different color. So can you see the background here? Okay, just a second. Okay, so can you see the background here? The background color here, this is the background, the entire background is known as stroma. In the stroma, we have third type of cells. You can see the third type of cells in the stroma. Can you see the third type of cells in the stroma? Let me mark it with another color. So these are the third type of cells within the stroma. These are known as interstitial. These are present in interstitium, interstitial cells of Leydig. So in the stroma, third type of cells, two type of cells are present in seminiferous tubules, and the third type is present in the stroma, known as interstitial cells of Leydig. Now, if you zoom it out and see any of the interstitial cell of Leydig, please concentrate. The cytoplasm contains multiple granules, pink colored granules. These are known as Ranicase crystal. What is the function of them? They also produce testosterone. So for hormone production or testosterone production, we have two types of cells. Number one, Sertoli cells, these one, which are present in the seminiferous tubule, and number two, interstitial cells of Leydig. And for sperm production, we have only one type of cells. Humans have only one type of cells, known as germ cells or spermatogenic cells, which are present in the seminiferous tubule. Have you got it? Say, have you got it? Yes or no? So what are the two types of cells in seminiferous tubule? This is a theory written in front of you. In seminiferous tubule, there are two types of cells, spermatogonia or germ cell, and number second is Sertoli cells. So these are the two types of cells. So spermatogonia forms spermatozoa, and Sertoli cells will produce testosterone and a little bit estrogen, and they provide supportive nutrition, nourishment to the germ cells. So these are the two types of cells here, and the third type of cells are present in the interstitium. known as interstitial cells of Leydig. They have granules in their cytoplasm, which are known as Wernicke's crystal. Very important MCQ. Very important MCQ. So these are present in the stroma. This one you can see. Done. So let me move ahead. What is the pathway of sperm? How sperms are formed, where they are formed, and how they come out of the body of a human male? So this is the testes. You can see sperms are formed inside this testes in the seminiferous tubules. So inside the testes, multiple seminiferous tubules are present. From the germ cell, sperms are formed in the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. From lumen of the seminiferous tubule, it will come in the reti testes. From reti testes, it will come to vas efferentia and epididymis. So you can see here is the reti testes and it is coming in the epididymis. This is epididymis. From epididymis, it is going in vas deferens. It is going into vas deferens. So from vas deferens, is connecting epididymis to the urethra. So here is the urethra. It is going to the urethra, and from urethra it is coming out of the body via penis. So this is the entire route. You can see how sperms are formed and how it comes out of the body. That was all about normal. So we have seen there are three types of cells in testes: germ cells, Leydig cells, Sertoli cells. Out of these three, germ cells and Sertoli cells are present in seminiferous tubules, and Leydig cells are present in the stroma. So what is the function of each of them? Germ cells produce sperms, and Leydig and Sertoli, both of them produce hormones, testosterone and estrogen. So in short, the function of testes is formation of sperms and formation of testosterone. Done. So let me start with the tumors without wasting time. I'm starting. If you have a basic idea what is the anatomy of testes and what is the histology of normal testes. Now if you learn the histology, understanding tumors is fun for you. So I'm starting with testicular tumor. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Are you people with me? Enjoying it? So these are the headings under which I'm going to cover this topic. First, I will tell you the classification of testicular tumors. So two type of classification I'm going to tell you: pathological classification, clinical classification. I will tell you both. Then I will tell you the risk factors, etiological factors or the risk factors for testicular tumor. Very, very important. Then I will tell you the clinical features with which patient is presenting to us. We are doctors. So patient present to us with certain clinical features. So what will be the clinical features said by the patient, stated by the patient? So you will have a suspicion that patient is having testicular tumor. Then I will tell you the routes of spread. What is the spread of this testicular tumor? Where it is spreading and what is the route of the spread? Then I will tell you tumor markers. Very important. What are the tumor markers of various types of testicular tumors? What is the tumor marker for seminoma, dysgerminoma? So various types. I will tell you the tumor, enumerate them. Then I will tell you the staging. Staging of how we do stage 1, 2, 3, 4. How we do the staging for testicular tumor. In the end, the most important, I will take one tumor from the classification and I will tell you gross and microscopy of each of them. Most of the MCQs are going to cover from this portion. You have to learn microscopy of all important testicular tumors. Give me a thumbs up if you people are with me. If you have any doubt, please write in the comment box. I will address it. Please write in the comment box. So we will cover in this way. So let me start. Okay. So let me start with the classification. As I have told you, I will tell you two types of classification. First, pathological, then clinical. So let me talk about the pathological classification of testicular tumors. Testicular tumors are of three types: germ cell tumors, sex cord tumors, and combined. So let me start. Germ cell tumors are most common tumors. 95% are germ cell tumors. Remaining sex cord and combined are only 5%. So let me talk about each of them one by one. Germ cell tumors are of 6 or 7 types, you can say. Sex cord tumors are of 3 types and combined is 1 type. So total 10 or 11 types of tumors are there. I will tell you all, don't worry. So germ cell tumors, here you can see germ cell tumors. So how many germ cell tumors are there? As I have told you, there are 7 types of germ cell tumors. So let me enumerate them. So first is seminoma. You can see seminoma. Then spermatocytic seminoma. Then embryonal carcinoma. Then yolk sac tumor, also known as endodermal sinus tumor. Polyembryoma. Then choriocarcinoma. And then last is teratoma. Now, how you will learn it? These all are germ cell tumors. So 7 germ cell tumors we have. So the mnemonic is YesPCT. The mnemonic is in front of you. You can see the mnemonic. Learn the mnemonics, please. So mnemonic is YesPCT. So YESPCT. Y stands for yolk sac, E for embryonal. There are two S. One is for seminoma, normal seminoma, classical seminoma. And second is spermatocytic seminoma, which is a special type of seminoma. So spermatocytic seminoma. So yolk sac, embryonal, seminoma. That is, if I say seminoma, it is classical. Then second is spermatocytic seminoma. then coming on polyembryoma, then choriocarcinoma, then teratoma. Yes or no? So these are the seven types of germ cell tumors. Seven type of germ cell tumors. Never forget. Many MCQs will come on the basis of classification. I will launch in the polls. Don't worry. The second are sex cord stromal tumors. So sex cord stromal tumors are three. The mnemonic is LSG. L for Leydig cell tumor. You can see Leydig cell tumor. S for Sertoli cell tumor. You can see the Sertoli cell tumor, also known as endoblastoma. And G is for granulosa cell tumor. The LSG is the mnemonic. Leydig cell, Sertoli cell and granulosa cell. Done. So mixed to sabhi mein aayenge. The last one is mixed. Mixed to sabhi mein aayenge. So you can skip the mixed one. Okay. So these are the sex cord tumors. And the third, combined germ cell as well as sex cord tumors. Combination of the two. So only one tumor, that is gonadoblastoma is there. Only one tumor, gonadoblastoma. So we are done with the classification. We are done with pathological classification. So who will help me in revising pathological classification? Then I will come on clinical classification. Who will help me in revising it? Who will help me in revising it? I will try. Who will help me among you? Someone? Someone among you? Okay. So let me start. Okay. So just a second. Okay. So who will tell me pathological classification? Pathological classification of testicular tumors. So testicular tumors are of three types. Just a second. Okay. So what are the three types of pathological classification of testicular tumors? What are the three types? It is germ cell tumors, also known as GCT, germ cell tumors, sex cord stromal tumors, sex cord stromal tumors. Second one. And the third one are combined germ cell and sex cord stromal combined. So who will tell me the mnemonics in each of them? Mnemonics. So total 11 type. What is the mnemonic? The mnemonic in the first category is, let me write, YEDSPCT. Yes, PCT. The mnemonic in the second category is LSG. The mnemonic in the third category, only G. So who will help me in saying the full form among you? Someone among you? Yes, who will help me in saying the full forms? So let me talk about germ cell tumors first. So Y stands for York sac. Y stands for York sac. Here, E stands for, E stands for embryonal carcinoma. S for seminoma, one S. Another S for spermatocytic seminoma. P for polyembryoma. C for choriocarcinoma. T for teratoma. Yes or no? LSG, Leydig cell carcinoma, Leydig cell tumor. Sertoli cell tumor, granulosa cell tumor. Leydig, Sertoli, granulosa. Leydig cell, Sertoli cell, granulosa. Leydig and Sertoli were the cells which are for hormone production. Remembering, Leydig was present in the interstitium and Sertoli cells were present in the spermatic cords and granulosa cell tumor. And combined mein only one gonadoblastoma. So no one can tell you it's easy classification. That is the best way I can tell you. That is pathological classification. Now I will mark next clinical classification in this only. So why I'm separating clinical classification from pathological classification? Someone can tell me why? Why there are two types of classification? I am separating clinical. So this is pathological classification, but clinician or a surgeon is not interested in this classification. What the surgeon is interested, he is first interested whether it is germ cell or non-germ cell. So all of these are included in non-germ cell tumor. So he is having two classes, germ cell tumors, GCT and NGCT, non-germ cell tumors. Ab germ cell mein bhi, he is not interested ki in saaton mein se kaun sa hai. Surgeon is interested whether it is seminoma or non-seminoma. So seminoma is separated from these seven and remaining six are in non-seminoma. So seminoma or non-seminoma. So that is I'm marking another classification. So another classification you can see here is, I'm writing here, clinical classification. So clinical classification you can write in this way. Clinical classification you can write in this way. Please help me in writing it. So the two classes, first divide, it is germ cell tumor or non-germ cell tumor. So germ cell tumor mein whether it is seminoma or non-seminoma. Non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. Non-seminoma mein remaining all will come. Non-seminoma also known as non-seminomatous germ cell tumor, NSGCT. In short, it is known as like this. So seminoma or non-seminoma. So seminoma includes only seminoma. Of course, seminoma includes only seminoma. Seminoma includes remaining YESPCT. PCT. The remaining six are there in non-seminoma. So, yolk sac, embryonal, spermatocytic seminoma, polyembryoma, choriocarcinoma, teratoma, all of them comes in non-seminomatous germ cell tumor, and seminoma comes in seminoma category. And non-germ cell tumor remaining sex cord tumors, that is Leydig cell, Sertoli cell, and granulosa cell, and gonadoblastoma. So, all of them, that is combined, and stromal are coming in non-germ cell. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Now, why we are separating? Tumors तो वही है, we are classifying in different ways. Why? Because this is clinical. Clinically फर्क पड़ता है. Treatment of all these is same and treatment of seminoma is different as compared to all these. So we want to separate whether it is seminoma. Why treatment is different? We will give radiotherapy to the seminoma. Seminomas respond best to the radiotherapy. They are very radiosensitive. So before doing surgery, we will give radiotherapy, RT. We will give radiotherapy to seminoma. But apart from seminoma, other tumors do not respond well to radiotherapy. These are radio resistant. So we have to give chemotherapy and we have to do the surgery. So treatment is entirely different. Prognosis is also different. Seminoma have a very good prognosis. And these all, remaining all, have poor prognosis. So prognosis is also different. Treatment is also different. Metastasis spread is also different. Seminoma spread very late. Very late spread is there and lymphatic spread is there. They spread by lymphatics. Here spread in non-seminoma YESPCT, spread is very fast. And that's why prognosis is poor. And spread is especially by blood. That is hematogenous. Hematogenous spread is there. So give me a thumbs up if you got it. So clinically we are interested whether it is seminoma or bacha hua anything. So bacha hua anything, the remaining all are included in a separate category known as non-seminoma. So I have done with two types of classification. So that was the pathological classification first I taught you. This is the clinical classification which I have taught you. So clinical classification, we discuss only seminoma and non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. So germ cell, first divide whether it is a germ cell tumor or it is a non-germ cell tumor. In germ cell tumor, you divide seminoma and remaining all will come in non-seminoma. Remaining all will come in non-seminoma. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. So these are the differences between seminoma and non-seminoma. You can see here. So as I have told you, seminoma are radiosensitive. So you will give radiotherapy as a part of treatment first. Non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. Non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. These are radio resistant. So you will not give radiotherapy as a part of treatment. You are a surgeon, you are a clinician. Seminoma are confined to the testes for a longer duration. 70% will be in stage 1 only. But here early dissemination is there. Or 60% will be in stage 2 or stage 3. So here early metastasis is there. Metastasis first to the lymph nodes in seminoma. But metastasis via blood in non-seminoma. Here tunica albuginea is spread. It is not speared. It is not spreading to the tunica. Here tunica is breached. That's why it is spreading early. So these are the differences. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I tried my best. So that was about the classification. On the classification, there are some MCQs which are already appeared in the past 5 year exams. NEET PG, FMG, INICT. INICT, I mean JIPMER, PGI, AIMS. So INICT is taking place from last two times. Na? Before that, these were the exams. So I have included past 5 year MCQs from all these 5-6 exams here based on this topic, based on classification of tumors. So you want me to show the MCQs? But here on YouTube, you know, now launching MCQ is difficult. I will launch the question in front of you, but there is no way to launch a poll and you can click the option. So that's why I always ask students to come on the special class on an academy app. Classes are free here also, classes are free there also. So for there, you have to install the app. That is the only thing. And you have to come for that special class. So I request all of you, those who are the newcomers here, please install the Unacademy app, learners app, go under NEET PG category, go under free special classes and watch all my lectures free of cost there, live as well as recorded. So here I will try to launch the questions in the form of the poll. This, so you can write your answer in the chat box. I will see the chat box. There is no other way to communicate with you other than chat box on YouTube. So this is the question in front of you. Please read the question and tell me the answer. I will read it for you. Okay. So all are germ cell tumors except, please mark, the question contains except. The four options are seminoma, Leydig cell tumor, embryonal carcinoma and endodermal sinus. So what will be your answer? Does anyone know the answer from the audience? So whosoever is listening, please write the answer. At best you will be wrong now. It's okay. It's okay to be wrong, but you will learn something. So please participate. Please participate. Write your answer. I'm looking on the comment box. No one have answered it yet. Please answer. Someone write in the chat box now whether I can see the chat box or not. Okay. Yes. So what is the correct answer here? Anyone? Yes. So most of you are correct. Okay. So the correct answer here is of course B. So germ cell tumor mein, you know, the mnemonic is YES PCT. This is the mnemonic. So here seminoma, you can see seminoma is coming here. Embryonal carcinoma is E here. And endodermal sinus tumor is the another name for yolk sac. So don't get confused. It is also a germ cell tumor. But Leydig cell tumor is coming in sex cord stromal tumor. The mnemonic was LSG. L was Leydig cell, S for Sertoli cell, G for granulosa cell. So Leydig cell was there. So correct answer here is B. Correct answer here is B. So B is the correct answer. This is the next question in front of you. Please solve it fast. Which of the following testicular tumor is not, please see not in the question, is the germ cell neoplasm? Again, same question with different options. Which is not a germ cell tumor? Which of the following? The four options are seminoma, yolk sac, Sertoli and teratoma. If you know the mnemonic, you can crack it. What is the mnemonic for germ cell tumor? As I have told you, what is the mnemonic? There are seven germ cell tumor. So what is the mnemonic for them? The seven germ cell tumors are in front of you. YESSPCT. If you know the full form, you can crack the MCQ. So seminoma lies here. Yolk sac tumor comes here. And teratoma. Teratoma also comes here. YESPCT ka T teratoma. But Sertoli cell tumor is not a germ cell tumor. It comes under another mnemonic LSG. That is sex cord stromal tumor. So sex cord stromal tumors are three. Leydig cell, Sertoli cell and granular cell, granulosa cell. So Sertoli cell is a sex cord tumor. So correct answer here is C because except is asked, not is asked in the question. So okay, done. This is the next question in front of you. Okay, only two questions were there. So I'm done with the classification. Should I move on to another heading? Give me a thumbs up if you got the classification. So I will tell you the risk factors for testicular tumor. I will come on the another heading, risk factors. What are the risk factors for testicular tumor? Does anyone know what are the risk factors for testicular tumor? So there are 5-6 risk factors. We will discuss them one by one. These are the 6 risk factors. The most important risk factor is cryptorchidism. Does anyone know what is cryptorchidism? The second is dysgenetic gonads. The third, there is genetic factors or family history. Then orchitis, that is an infection in the testes. Trauma to the testes. Or there are some carcinogens present in the environment, drugs, chemicals. So let me discuss one by one. These are the 6 risk factors which increases the chances of having testicular tumor in a male. So testicular tumor in a male, the chances will increase if any of these risk factors is present. So first is cryptorchidism. What is cryptorchidism? What is cryptorchidism? Cryptorchidism is failure of descent of testes. You know, during embryonal time, the testes is formed in the abdomen. This is the abdominal cavity. But it descends slowly, and ultimately it comes in the scrotum just before birth. There is 9 months of gestational period, no? So, during the 9 month of gestational period, at the seven month, it is the testes is reaching inguinal ring. The testes is reaching deep inguinal ring. At the 8th month, it is reaching inguinal canal. You can see it is reaching inguinal canal here. And at the 9 month, it is reaching superficial inguinal pouch. It is coming to the superficial inguinal pouch. And just before birth, at term, it is reaching the scrotum. It is coming at the scrotum. So it is finally coming at the scrotum just before. So it is at the 7 month of gestation, 8 month, 9 month, and just before birth. That is at term child. That is 9 month, 9 days. We know. So if any male baby is there, male child is there inside the uterus of the mother. So the testes of the male child is formed intra-abdominally. Then it descend, and finally it comes. It comes in the scrotum and it will lie in the scrotum forever. Done. Why? I have already told you why testes lie outside the body, outside the cavity in a separate sac known as scrotum. Because sperm formation requires lower temperature as compared to cold body temperature. That is the reason. And the descent is guided by gubernaculum. So that is normal phenomenon. But failure to descend. In some males, in some babies, testes do not descend. They remain. Kahin na kahin atak jayegi beech mein. They remain at some of the position inside the body only, inside the abdominal cavity or pelvic cavity only. So this phenomenon is known as cryptorchidism. So what is cryptorchidism? It is complete or partial failure of intra-abdominal testes to descend into the scrotal sac. So testes is not coming in the scrotal sac. It is remaining in the intra-abdominal organ only. Done. That is known as cryptorchidism. So what is the problem? What is the problem? Whether testes remain here or it comes here? How does it matter to the child? So when the child is born, the scrotum is empty. So usually noticed by the parents, by the mother, father, and they come to a doctor, they will come to you carrying their baby that testes have not descended, scrotum is empty. So in premature babies, it is common because complete descent occurs at 9 months. So wait till term, the corrected age of the baby. If the baby is preterm, usually it will descend. But in some babies, it is not descending. Then what is the problem? Does child have some pain or some problem? No, child absolutely is symptom free. Child will not have any symptom apart the scrotum is empty. Scrotum doesn't contain testes. Now it can be unilateral, it can be bilateral. Sometimes one testes is present, another is not present in the scrotum, or both are absent in the scrotum, both are present intra-abdominally. Done. So this can happen unilateral and bilateral. So what are the clinical features? So child will not have any symptoms, but at puberty, at 13 to 14 years, normally puberty comes. At puberty, testes start forming testosterone. In this child, testosterone is not formed, sperms are not formed, sperms. So this child will be infertile. Infertile after puberty, the child will be infertile. Infertility will be a problem, number one. Or second, the testes, when present intra-abdominally, this testes have high, 50 times high risk of having testicular carcinoma. Testicular carcinoma. So testes is always at high risk of developing testicular carcinoma, especially seminoma. Which testicular carcinoma? It is seminoma. So this testes is always at high risk. So it is always better to get this testes descent surgically. So surgically we do this surgery and the name of the surgery is orchidopexy. So what the surgeon do? Take the testes from here and put it in the scrotum. So both the problems will be solved. So person will not be infertile because it is coming in the scrotum. And yeah, but after doing orchidopexy also, the testes is at increased risk only. So if it is done in the childhood only, at 1 year of age, the risk decreases. But after that, there is no decrease in the risk. So better to perform the surgery between 1 year to 2 years of the age, of the after first birthday of the child. So that is orchidopexy. The name of the surgery is orchidopexy. So have you got the first risk factor for the tumors, testicular tumors, is cryptorchidism. Let me change the color. Okay. So cryptorchidism. The first is cryptorchidism. Then, so such testes is at 50 times higher risk of developing a tumor. Done. So you know what is cryptorchidism? I have already taught you what is cryptorchidism. So you can see testes is not descending. It is remaining as an intra-abdominal organ only. It is not coming in the scrotum. It is not coming in the scrotum. There is a block in between somewhere. The block can be internal inguinal ring, external inguinal ring, superficial inguinal ring, or anywhere, or in the intra-abdominal organ, in the intra-abdominally only. So block can be anywhere. The second risk factor is dysgenetic gonads. Dysgenetic gonads. So we know there are many diseases in which person will have dysgenetic gonads. So most important is androgen insensitivity syndrome. So the person is at high risk of developing testicular tumor. Testicular tumor, high risk. Second is genetic factors. There is some gene. The gene is not known till. But there is some gene which is involved in testicular tumor. But it is not yet discovered. It is not yet discovered. Why we are saying there is some gene? Because we have seen if some family relative is having test, if the father is having testicular tumor, there are high chances son will also have. So if first degree relative have testicular tumor, it runs in the family. So there should be some gene. Nah? And we have also noticed that if one of the monozygotic twin is having testicular tumor, other will also have. So there is high concordance rate. So that is again indicating there is some genes. There is some genetic factor, but yet it is not discovered. It is about to discover, you can say. The fourth risk factor is orchitis. So when we sit in our OPD and when patients come with testicular tumor and we take the history, do you have any infection in your testes in the past? They usually give a history, we have mumps in the past. In the testes, we have an infection of mum or other infections. So it is indicating infection can increase carcinogenesis process. It can happen, but we are not sure. Next, when we take the history from patients again, then many patients give a history of trauma just before the tumor. So we tell them you have testicular tumor. When we take the history, they say, yeah, some months back I have testicular trauma. So again, it is indicating trauma can initiate the process, but again, we are not sure. It can happen. The last is there are many carcinogens present in the drugs like LSD, hormonal therapy, copper, zinc, radiation, which increases the chances of having testicular tumor. So these are the risk factors. We are done with the classification. All of you know the two types of classification, the pathological classification, clinical classification. So now we have done with etiological factors also. So there are six etiological factors. All of you know the six etiological factors. Yes or no? Should I come on the clinical features now? Clinical features of testicular tumor. What the patient comes to us with, what complaint? So usually patient comes with a complaint of gonadal enlargement, scrotal, unilateral scrotal enlargement. Pain is not there. Some dragging sensation. Khichav sa lagta hai, in Hindi patient says. So scrotal enlargement is there, unilateral, either left or right. So unilateral scrotal enlargement. So inside the scrotum, one of the testes is getting enlarged and dragging sensation is there. But if metastasis is present, any of the symptom can come. So patient can come with pain, lymphadenopathy, hemoptysis, urinary obstruction, depending what is the site of metastasis. If site of metastasis is lung, he will come with hemoptysis. If site of metastasis is urinary bladder, he will come with urinary obstruction. It can be site of metastasis is lymph nodes, he will come with lymphadenopathy. So these are the features of metastasis. So these are the clinical features. Now coming on the next heading, spread. What is the spread? How testicular tumor spread? What is the spread? There are two routes, lymphatic route and hematogenous route. By two routes, testicular tumor spread. Lymphatic route, you have to learn the name of the lymph nodes. So the name of the lymph nodes is retroperitoneal lymph node, para-aortic lymph node, sometime mediastinal and supraclavicular also. Retroperitoneal, para-aortic, supraclavicular and mediastinal, that is in the chest, thorax. So these are the lymph nodes. Hematogenous route, it will spread to lungs, liver, brain and bone. So these are the two routes. Usually, seminoma spread by lymphatic route, seminoma, and non-seminoma, remaining except seminoma, all other germ cell tumors, these are known as non-seminoma. Non-seminomatous germ cell tumors, that is York sac, embryonal, choriocarcinoma, teratoma, you know the names. So these all spread by hematogenous route. So again, very important MCQ, seminoma spread by lymphatic and non-seminomatous germ cell tumor spread by hematogenous, you have to learn it. So we are done with classification, the risk factors, clinical features, spread. Now I'm telling you about tumor markers. What do you mean by tumor markers? Does anyone know what is tumor marker? What are tumor markers? For tumor markers, we withdraw blood sample from the patient. So from the patient, we have taken a blood sample out. In the blood sample, we will see for these markers. We will see for beta-HCG, alpha-fetoprotein, LDH, lactate dehydrogenase, and plaque. PLAP, placental alkaline phosphatase, KIT on OCT4. These are the name for proteins. All of them are proteins. So these are the proteins. These are the proteins or oncogens, oncoproteins, and these are present. Normally, these are not present in the blood. But when patient is having testicular tumor, so these are the two testes. One of the testes is having a tumor. One of the testes. So this testes, the tumor wala testes, will secrete these proteins in the blood. So in the blood, these proteins will be secreted by the tumor in the testes. So their concentration in the blood will increase. So we are not doing the biopsy of the tumor. We are just withdrawing the blood. So it is a very simple test. You ask your patient to give their blood sample. It is a very simple test. So they usually convince it is a non-invasive test. Na? Patient has to give only blood sample. And in the blood sample, you have to see for these markers. So these markers, again, you know the list. Now, what is the list? So the list is YESPCT. You know the full form. So these all are germ cell tumors. So from all these germ cell tumors, seminoma, separate seminoma, seminoma secrete all these. PLAP, KIT and OCT4. These three are secreted by seminoma. So if in the blood of the patient you find PLAP, you find KIT and you find OCT4, it has to be seminoma. These are specific markers for seminoma. Remaining markers. Let me change the color. Okay, so remaining all markers. So which markers? Beta-HCG, AFP and LDH. These are raised in non-seminoma. Non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. That is York sac, embryoma, spermatocytic seminoma, polyembryoma, choriocarcinoma and teratoma. So these are raised in that, but not in seminoma. So see the color. With green color, I have marked seminoma. With black color, I have marked non-seminoma. So seminoma ki markers batao. PLAP, KIT, OCT4. These are the three markers for seminoma. Non-seminoma ki markers batao. Again three markers. Beta-HCG, AFP, LDH. Ye jo teen marker hai. Beta-HCG, AFP aur LDH. Ab non-seminoma mein kaun sa kiska hai? So beta-HCG specially in choriocarcinoma. AFP specially in York sac. And LDH in all of them. Except seminoma. So you have to learn it. Should I summarize it again? Or have you got it? So I will summarize it again. Okay. So let's see, just a second, let me go. Okay. So what I have told you, seminoma and non-seminoma, non-seminomatous germ cell tumor, that is YES, ek S hata do, PCT. The second S is coming here, seminoma. So these are the two types of tumors. What are the markers? Just enumerate the markers. In seminoma, it is PLAP, placental alkaline phosphatase. It is not acid phosphatase, it is alkaline phosphatase. Kyunki MCQ mein acid phosphatase bhi aata hai. That's why I am just highlighting it. So second is PLAP ke baad OCT and Oxford, and third is KIT, K-I-T, KIT. You have to learn. These are the name of the proteins which are present in a patient having seminoma. Now, let me enumerate the markers for non-seminoma. Let me enumerate the markers. It is AFP. AFP, specially in yolk sac. ये जो yolk sac है, इसमें मिलेगा AFP. दूसरा beta-HCG. Beta-HCG. Beta-HCG present in choriocarcinoma. ये जो choriocarcinoma है, उसमें मिलेगा beta-HCG. और तीसरा LDH. LDH is present in all of them. LDH. These markers, beta-HCG and LDH also present in 10% of the seminoma, but not all seminoma, only 10%. So that was the all summary about it. I tried my best. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Very, very important. Many MCQs will come from this topic. Believe me. Done. So that was all about tumor markers. Now coming on the staging. So there are four stages. We already know. So there are four stages in any tumor. So likewise in testes also, there are four stages. Just a second. There are four stages in testes. You can see stage 1, 2, 3. So stage 1, tumor is confined to the testes only. Stage 2, tumor is spreading to the lymph nodes, retroperitoneal lymph nodes below the diaphragm. And stage 3, tumor is spreading to both side diaphragm, above and below. And stage 4 is distentment. So staging is very easy. So we are done with the staging. Now what is remaining? The most important portion is remaining. Gross and microscopy of individual tumor. So seminoma, yolk sac, teratoma, all tumors, gross as well as microscopy. So I advise you to make this table. I will explain three of them: seminoma, yolk sac, teratoma. Out of these, I will explain three. Out of the six, I will explain these three, the most important three. So please make this table with me, as notes are not available. Please make, take a notebook, take a pen and make this table with me. So write the introduction of each of them, important points. Gross, one word in the gross, the most important on which MCQ will come. Microscopy, draw microscopy for each of them. I will simplify it to such an extent you can't imagine. And tumor markers. I will tell you tumor markers also. Okay. But I'm just ending this lecture as time is finished. So I will join you again just after 10 minutes at sharp 10 a.m. At sharp 10 a.m. Come again. Come again at sharp 10 a.m. I will see you again. Join another link, episode 2 of testicular tumor. On the YouTube only this session is there and we will continue it. So see you back. Don't go anywhere. Okay. I'm ending this lecture.